tourists.
You lift them a bit too high.
That's funny. My father used to tell me the same thing. How do you know?
I just love music.
It's been my lifeline, frankly. But I only play it out loud when Irene and my stepsisters are away.
That idiot woman is your stepmother?
It's another long story that I don't particularly like telling.
For the kitchen help, you've got quite a colorful past. How did you start playing?
My father taught me. He always hoped I'd be as good as my mother, but no chance. She was an amazing pianist.
You seem pretty good yourself.
Not good enough. I didn't get into the conservatory. They rejected me because I wasn't formally trained.
This piece.
Do you like it? My mother started writing it for me before she died, and my father finished it. Every time I play it, it feels like I'm talking to her. Wasn't she beautiful? She must have been my age here. My father was pretty handsome too, though.
Father.
He joined her several years ago.
And you have no one else left?
A couple distant aunts on my father's side, but no one on my mother's side. She was from Boston, you know.
Her family was pretty mean anyways.
Especially my grandmother. She had cut all ties with her before her death. Pretty unforgivable, if you ask me. Are you all right?
I'm feeling a little lightheaded. I think I should probably lie down.
I'll help you back to your room. Here you go.
Your hands are so cold.
Always. Do you want me to come and check on you later?
Please.
Okay.
So?
It's her. I've checked the records.
That goddamn Valerio. He hated me so much he didn't want me to know.
Sounds like the feeling was mutual. So why are you so surprised? Make up your mind, Laura. Either you're happy or you're upset.
How can I not be upset? All those wasted years when she could have been in my life.
Just try and look at the upside. At least now, you're ready. Believe me, you've been given a second chance. But you've got to tell her the truth.
See, I was right all along. I could tell right away that she was of that class. But that's the game you play with those moneyed people. They respect you more if you don't kiss up to them.
Well, since I'm not the owner, I have no choice but to kiss up.
That's right.
Hello? Is this Cooper?
Oh. How are you feeling today, Mrs. Cooper?
had a rough night, but I'm much better now, thank you. Hang it in the closet.
Yes.
Oh. You're an official rival now.
Just playing another game, that's all. Speaking of which, any new developments in your romantic life?
He didn't even remember our conversation. I don't know how that's possible.
Don't even go there.
But he's throwing a ball for his new girlfriend.
Well, seems like your love is being tested, my dear.
He's so changed. I'm on the verge of giving up, frankly.
Then it's not true love after all.
Please, don't burst my bubble.
Look, if you really believe that the boy you love is somewhere inside that shell, it should be your mission to save him. But you need to do it before it's too late.
But I don't even know how to see him again. He's hired a new cook.
Don't worry. We'll figure something out.
No. No. Absolutely no one knew. She kept a very low profile. Look, there's no need to shout at me, Father. I can hear you perfectly. I'll deal with it the best I can.
Sorry, good day, gentlemen.
Today is not a good day.
I know. I need only a minute. Did you know that Mrs. Cooper is staying at my hotel?
Well, I doubt she picked it for its charm.
Well, it's quite special. You should stop by one day.
We'll take care of it later.
Oh, a masked ball. How lovely. Well, if you need any assistance...
Henry?
Dear.
Oh, hello, Augsburg resident.
Thank you.
Tina.
Hi. Well, if you're calling to check out the invitations, they look spectacular.
Could you see her?
Very well.
Yes, they should be out for tomorrow. What time do you want me to pick you up? Yes, darling. I can't wait.
Prince, would you like us to cover the ball too?
That might be a bit much.
Well, now you've started it. Once you're in the front page for a couple of times, you become newsworthy. You might as well just keep the fire going.
Let me think about it. Do you have connections in America?
Well, depends on what you need.
Anything incriminating on her, I'll pay you extra if you deliver it fast.
White.
I think I'll go black.
Me too.
That's more slimming.
Can't wait.
You're invited?
Why are you so surprised?
Because you're not.
Goodbye, my dear Lord.
Aurora! I need your help!
Can you check what it is? I don't know what I did with my glasses.
You're invited?
It's for you.
But how?
My friend Bobby is making a movie in town. These people have connections.
I don't know what to say.
Just enjoy it. You'll have a great time.
But how can I enjoy it? I mean, look at me. That world is totally out of my league.
Nonsense. You can belong to any world you want. Besides, it's a mask ball. You can be whoever you want.
But only until midnight. Then all the masks come off.
That's the fun part. Of course, if you're brave enough. Look, just go and make him fall in love with you. That's your goal for the night.
It's a pretty tall order.
Go now, and try to sneak out tomorrow.
Yeah.
I assume you'll need a gown.
No, actually, I have something in mind.
Thank you.
What time is it?
Your mother would really love it.
You don't like it. I can tell you don't.
No. Quite the opposite. I think it's exquisite. Lift the hem, will you?
Don't laugh at me.
It's hard not to. You're such a tomboy.
I have to be practical when I buy things. She barely gives me any money.
Pick a pair and try them on. You have very tiny feet.
I know. Let me just have some paper. Oh.
Now, cross the room back and forth. Be careful, dear. If you knock your teeth out, you can forget about the ball.
I told you I was hopeless.
Not hopeless. Charming.
You did a terrific job here, Sebastian.
I like the ball idea, too. It was very clever of you.
I'm glad you both approve.
Just don't allow anyone in here, okay? I don't want herds of people running upstairs. Keep it down to the pavilion.
What was the last thing Martone said to you?
Well, he never rejected our offer. I think he's just playing the game, too.
Cooper must have offered him much more money.
Probably, but no one knows how much. I have another suspicion, though, why he's suddenly stalling.
It's his daughter, isn't it?
You think she may have some hopes?
Well, with all that publicity, I wouldn't be surprised. What's your take on it?
Do you think if I took another step, it would help the deal?
You're asking me?
Well, if that's what it takes, I'll propose to Tina at the ball.
Don't be so flippant about it, darling. This is your personal life.
Claudia, I generally love your input, but please, stay out of this when you're too emotional.
And you're too driven.
That's why we're such a perfect match, aren't we? You always know how to keep me in check.
Take the ladies up to number 5.
Please, this way.
Thank you.
May I help you?
Mrs. DeLuca, I presume. You don't call, you don't write. We actually thought you were dead.
I beg your pardon?
I'm an inspector from the tax office. Very pleased to find you in good health, madam.
Thank you.
On our midnight tryst or something.
Let's hope you will, after the ball.
I came here so many times with my father, but it seems like a different lifetime now.
Thank you, goodbye.
Bye.
Hello, good morning, then.
Good morning. Ah, this is what I'm looking for.
It's too small. I swear, it's just too tight.
Not if it takes an inch off your waist.
My mother must have had a smaller frame.
But she was just as tall as you, unless you've shortened the dress. Don't you have anything else?
No, I'm sorry, this is all that we have. I can't believe this. They're all too big.
Seems like not many rich women are your size, my dear.